Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 32. This week I'm post-processing a photo from Castillo de San Cristobal, a 17th century Spanish fortress in San Juan, Puerto Rico. This is a shot of the troop quarters. It's awash in light and shadows, but suffering from poor composition. So today I'm going to demonstrate the power of a good crop when your in-camera composition isn't quite what you want. I'll begin by cycling through my crop overlays. And I come up to the crop tool and open it. And to cycle through the overlays, you simply hit the O key on your keyboard. This is the grid overlay. There's the rule of thirds. This is called the diagonal. This is called the triangle. I use this an awful lot. And here's the golden ratio. And this is the one that I'm going to use for this picture. First, I'm going to drag in from the right, and I'm going to center that right line, the grid line, in the middle of the archways to force my focal point there. I'm also going to pull down the top, and I'm going to bring it down to about here. So that this point is on the uppermost part of the arch. I'm going to pull this in a bit on the window, and then I'm going to click done. So already there is a vast improvement. I feel as if I'm standing directly in front, or that I am just being drawn into this series of archways more so than before. But I want to do a few other quick edits just to make this a little bit more pleasing to the eye. And actually, I did forget that what I want to do is rotate a bit to level this off. Leave it about there. So there we go. Now I'm done. At this point, I'm going to come into my clarity and I'm going to boost that up, which increases the saturation just a little bit, not too much. Because I'm not increasing it too much, but just gives a little bit more definition to the photo. I'm also going to come down into my details panel and apply sharpening. And I have over here on the left panel, I have presets. And actually, these are presets that are loaded in with Lightroom 5. I'm going to click on Sharpen Scenic, and you'll see the values change. And the reason this is red here is because I have highlighted where my white clipping is occurring. And I'm going to uncheck that box and remove that. Yes, I know there is clipping going on in the overexposed areas, but that's okay. That's what this is about, the light and the shadows. There's no detail here to be lost. The last thing I'm going to do is come down and apply post-crop vignette. I typically do this with all my photos, and I can go from simple to very strong. This one, I just want a very simple, a minus 10. So let's go to the before. Let me come back here. Where is it? Let's get to the before. There we go. There's the before, and there's the after. Please let me know if you think the post-processing created a better image. I'd love to know your comments. For those watching on YouTube, you can see or you can find links to more after and before galleries at visualventuring.com in the After Before Friday forum. Thanks for watching, everyone.